Got a handful of watercolors here and they'll be listed below, but these are from my mixed palette that I've created for florals. And I'm using my favorite watercolor brushes, a number 4 and a number 8 silver black velvet, and I'll have that information listed below as well. I've got a jar of water here, and I'm using my favorite watercolor paper for paper crafting. It's 100% cotton. It's from B Paper Company. Okay, so we're going to get into it, and we're going to start to talk about water to paint ratios. Okay, so this next section is a bit longer, but I promise you're going to get a lot of value out of it, and I've got a lot of great tips for water to paint ratios. So we're going to break it down into 3 different chunks here for water ratios: skim milk, 2% milk, and whole milk. One of the biggest questions I get from people are, how do I control the watercolor? Watercolor wants to go with the flow, so you use water and the amount of water and the ratio to paint to create different looks. So I've broken this down. So skim milk is using a lot of water in your paint to break down that pigment and get the lightest value of color. So this is like a wash of color, what I call the first layer or underpainting of your stamped image or your painting. So again, skim milk, think of it that way, because skim milk is really watery. So we're watering down the paint and the pigment, and we're getting that skim milk consistency. Now, to create a stronger value, which would be more of the consistency of like 2% milk, your water to paint ratio would be less water and more pigment. So you have more paint, and you can see me drying off my brush a little bit more so that it's not sopping wet, and I get more pigment. So I'm adding less water to the paint, so I'm controlling it a little bit more, and I'm getting more pigment. So you can get different values of color, and I'm using Quinacridone Coral, by the way, which I love. Love that color. And I've got 2 different values of this color just by controlling the ratio of water that I'm using. So skim milk, a lot of water, 2% milk, a little bit less water, I get more pigment, and I've changed the value of the color. So skim milk, 2% milk. It's kind of a great way to think about it. And this is the way that you can control the value of your paint and your pigment, by adding water. So once you learn how to use the water, you can let the watercolor go with the flow. So a 2% milk is going to give you a stronger value of color. And I'm loving the differences between that. One other thing I want to mention is that when you're working with watercolor, it's always, when it's wet, it's always a lot, the value is always stronger looking. When it dries and seeps into the watercolor paper, it will dry back, sometimes even a shade or two. Okay, so now we're going to talk about whole milk, which would be a lot of pigment and less water. Now, these black velvet brushes are what I call thirsty brushes. So they love water and they take on a lot of water. And you can see here as I'm painting, I have very little water in my brush, and I'm painting on to the 100% cotton paper. So I'm getting like these little edges that are kind of scratchy looking, because there's no water here. This is like full strength, a little tiny bit of water, full strength color, and I end up getting these little scratchy edges around my swatch here, which makes it kind of interesting. But you can see that we've got a full strength of color here, but you can start to see the 3 different values here that have been completely controlled by the amount of water you've added to the paint. So a little bit of water means you've got a lot of pigment, and it's what I would call whole milk. So it's more of our creamier, full strength consistency of the paint. So you can take a look here. You can see here, using 100% cotton papers, when you don't use a lot of water, they are super thirsty. They want water and they want to soak it in. So to get this buttery, creamy, full strength consistency, you use less water. To get the 2% consistency, it's a stronger value than it is the skim milk, but it is a, you know, watered down a little bit. And then skim milk is like our first wash of color, like super duper watered down. Okay, so just want to do a quick review. We talked all about water to paint ratio today. We talked about skim milk, 2% milk, and whole milk, and how you can use water to change the value of the color that you are using. Now look at this. Look at the depth of color and how luminous the colors look in the flowers. Thanks so much for joining me. Please consider sharing the joy by liking this video and subscribing to this channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.